This YCN segment is brought to you by New London Hospital, an affiliate of Dartmouth Hitchcock.
Welcome back, YCN Sports Talk. Jeremy Stout, Dustin Ribellini in studio, and we move over to baseball as the weather seems to warm up. I know we're not out of the winter yet, but it's a nice day out there today. And coming up, hopefully we'll have some warmer weather. Pitchers and catchers reporting for most teams this week. Like I said, all the other players, position players, will be in by Monday for most teams. That's always good. Just get the, you know, you got a little bit of time between the Super Bowl and spring training, a week or two, but now baseball is getting ready to start.
Yeah, you kind of got that lull after football season, before basketball season really hits the stretch run, both in college and NBA. Get yourself your blood boiling for those big-time baseball fans, which both we are.
Yes.
Hopefully it means the spring's coming. I think we're still a ways from that in our region. But yeah. Either way, it's good to have baseball back and getting ready for another good season.
And before we get into the players and the season, obviously on the hot stove or cold stove, just the talk right now, the topic is all these unsigned players are even having a special spring training for some of them. Some of them are being the Scott Boras ones are potentially doing their own spring training. So what are your thoughts overall? I mean, is this a problem? Is one side more to blame than the other? Or is this just the way a free market works? If the owners don't want to pay the price that the players want, that's just going to have, somebody's going to have to go.
Yeah, I don't think it's a problem for baseball. I think it's becoming what the norm is. You and I could sit here for the whole show and list the players who have signed 6, 7, 8 year deals that turned out bad.
Yeah.
Jacoby Ellsbury, Carl Crawford, Dustin Pedroia, not just on our teams, across baseball.
Yep.
Albert Pujols, even though he's had some decent seasons, he's not what he used to be when he signed that 10-year deal. The Alex Rodriguez deal was terrible. These teams are not going to give these guys in their 30s those 6, 7, 8 year deals that are expiring when they're close to 40. It's just the way, not only this year, going forward, you're not going to see people take deals past maybe 34, 35. And I think that's what guys like J.D. Martinez, Eric Hosmer, Jake Arrieta, what they're looking at right now is J.D. Martinez wants a deal for 8 years. He's 31 years old.
Right.
That's not going to happen. So I think you're going to see this not only this year, but down the road. And I don't think it's a problem for baseball. I think the owners and the players need to say, hey, look, if we can get a 3, 4 year deal for maybe more money annually, we got to take it.
Right. And also you've seen some of these players sign early before they hit arbitration or before they hit free agency, kind of given that quote-unquote hometown discount, and they realize that, hey, if I can get the guaranteed money right now, yeah, I'm a couple years away from free agency, and that's what the players' union doesn't want them to see, doesn't want to happen, or agents, because
right.
They think they can go for more. But some of these guys, whether it be a Jose Altuve, I know he signed a deal early, they know they're good, they want that guarantee, and they don't mind shaving a few dollars off the end. And so, I mean, it's all going to resolve itself. J.D. Martinez is going to play this year,
right.
But it's just going to be interesting to see what happens, and going forward, does this mean fewer dollars as free agents, or are people just holding their money for next year's free agent class? I mean, that's a thing that we could see, because they want to reset from the luxury tax, and next year's going to be a big free agent class.
Yeah, there's a lot of big names. Bryce Harper, Manny Machado lead the way, and I think you want to reset that luxury tax so you get the higher salary cap next year.
So now getting onto the field, obviously lots to go, free agents to sign, spring training to happen. But if you're, you know, handicapping that American League, I know there's going to be a lot of the same faces and the same names, but who are you looking at as the class of that of the American League?
Well, I think it's got to start with the defending champion, Houston Astros. And they won the championship last year. They had a pitcher like Gerrit Cole. They had a couple bullpen arms, and they're still looking at the hitter market maybe to acquire the catcher from Miami, Real Muto. So I think they're definitely the team to beat because they got Verlander now for the full season.
Right.
Again, with Dallas Keuchel, with Gerrit Cole, with how well they played last year, they got the reigning MVP. I think it starts and ends with them, and then you have the same faces, Cleveland, New York, Boston, just a step below.
Now, Cleveland and New York, clearly a step below right now Houston, but are they both on the same level, or are we, you know, I don't want to say we're overvaluing New York, and you're a Yankees fan, and they obviously added some pieces. I think they're the team to beat in the American League East, but are we getting ahead of ourselves? Because that Cleveland team last year, they won like 100, I think 100 games, so let's not forget they're there. Obviously, the Yankees are better, but where do we rate those two teams?
I think they're really close, and we saw the Yankees beat them in 5 last year in the ALDS. The only thing about that Cleveland team is, yeah, they won 100 games, but they won like 23 in a row. That never happened.
Right.
You know, so like kind of like the Celtics,
yeah.
If they win 15 of 23, they win what, 93 games instead of 100. So that's a little – I think Cleveland's very good. I think them and the Yankees are right on par.
All right, I agree that the Yankees are there. They're the class of the American League East quickly. In the National League, obviously the Dodgers are right there. The Cubs, with the new signing of Darvish, they're right back in the mix as well after kind of a down year last year.
I think the Cubs are probably the favorite right now because their rotation is off the charts. When you start Lester, Darvish, and Quintana as your top 3, and I think the Cubs, and Joe Maddon said it, they weren't focused last year.
Right.
They won the World Series. They were not focused. So I think you're going to see the Cubs maybe not get all the way, but they're going to be a team to beat to start the season.
Exactly. And we have lots to talk about in the next 6 weeks. Baseball spring training coming up. So every week we'll touch on a little bit more of that. When we come back, we'll talk some Patriots. Final wrap-up of the season and looking towards next year, obviously. They have some pieces to fill, but some pieces coming back as well. We'll take a break. You're watching YCN Sports Talk.